In the 1960s, Dr. Ray Davis, a chemist from Brookhaven National Laboratory, identified the mine as the ideal location to establish his solar neutrino experiment. Once referred to as ghost particles, these elusive neutrinos originate from the sun during the nuclear fusion process. Mark Hanhart is an experiment support scientist in Leeds and has followed Davis's research.
So if you were to take every atom in the universe, so I'm talking about every atom in your body, every atom in the world, every atom in the galaxy, and break them down into the protons and the neutrons and the electrons, the number of neutrinos in the universe would still outnumber those by 1,000,000,000,000.
The trouble is, they're almost impossible to detect.
A neutrino doesn't have an electric charge. It doesn't couple to the electromagnetic field. So it passes through normal matter. It passes through you and me. It passes through even the mile of rock that we have overhead. And they're incredibly, incredibly hard to detect.
And the only way to find them was to go underground.
Ray Davis came up with the brilliant idea of coming underground to block out cosmic rays, to study the reactions that take place inside the sun.
By going underground, Davis was able to avoid cosmic ray interactions that could affect his results.
And that's something that you can't do on the surface, because the surface is constantly bombarded with cosmic rays coming from the sun, from the upper atmosphere, from intergalactic sources, also coming from cell towers, radio towers. Even human beings put off a level of radioactivity. They would overwhelm the signals that we're trying to pick up with these incredibly sensitive detectors. So our entire goal in coming underground is to escape all the noise on the surface.
When Ray Davis first started working on his experiment, Homestake was still an active mine.
Getting down here meant that he had to fit the schedule of the mine itself. He had to be down here when they were blasting in areas that were not too far away.
Davis came up with a clever way to search for neutrinos using a chemical compound similar to dry cleaning liquid.
Now we're in the lower Davis cavern. This is the same space that Ray Davis started installing his equipment in 1965.
Davis set up a large tank of chlorine-rich liquid in the hopes that some of the neutrinos would interact with some of the chlorine atoms and form argon atoms. By counting the argon atoms, the number of neutrinos coming from the sun could be detected. However, an interesting thing happened when Davis searched for those solar neutrinos. Only about 1/3 of the predicted number were detected. This anomaly became known as the solar neutrino problem. Ultimately, Davis's experiment was considered a major scientific breakthrough, and he was awarded the Nobel Prize for identifying different flavors or types of neutrinos.
His experiment was incredibly successful. It introduced one of the most important and lasting mysteries in physics.
Yet long before the scientists made their home here, the mining industry created the groundwork for everything that would eventually become possible. During the 1870s, prospectors arrived ready to make their fortune in the Black Hills gold rush.
The Homestake Mine became one of the longest enduring gold mines and oldest gold mine listed on the New York Stock Exchange.
David Vardaman is a former Homestake miner who now works at the Sanford Underground Research Facility.
45 years ago, as a college student, I went to work for Homestake Mining Company. We had just reached the 8,000 foot level, and my area of responsibility was the mapping and geologic control and identifying locations of ore in the deep underground for the Homestake Mine.
But working a mile underground is no easy feat.
The 8,000 foot level is 132 degrees Fahrenheit rock temperatures. So it's a lot of challenges on ventilation, hoisting, personnel, equipment, you name it. This mine was the cutting edge of its time.
For over 125 years, miners pulled more than 40 million ounces of gold from the mine. To the locals, a seemingly limitless amount of riches was buried deep in the ground, just waiting to be unearthed. Yet, in 2002, that limit was reached, and the mine was forced to close because of high production costs. But it was not forgotten. 5 years later, new life was resurfacing at Homestake Mine. But instead of hunting for gold, advocates for underground science were determined to shed light on one of the biggest mysteries in the universe. After over a century of lucrative gold production, the Homestake Mine, located in South Dakota, took on a whole new purpose. In 2007, the Homestake Mine transitioned into a dedicated subterranean research lab called the Sanford Underground Research Facility, or SURF, designed to solve some of the universe's biggest mysteries. Above ground, the original mine infrastructure is still operating and is currently the main mode of transportation in and out of the lab.
When one cage is going down, the other one is coming up. 77,000 pounds worth of weight that this hoist mechanism is pulling up. This is a vintage piece of hoist gear. You will not see these running other than in museums. Yet here, it has been rebuilt, maintained to support science, cutting edge science with 1930 vintage technology.
Now, a new kind of mining is taking place.
We're looking to understand certain properties of the neutrino that make them really important to our story for how we came to be in the universe. We're trying to understand if neutrinos are their own antiparticles. And if they are, that would explain a big chunk of what's missing from the current Big Bang theory.
Even though dark matter makes up nearly 85% of all matter in the universe, we don't really know much about it. What we do know is that it exists, based on the impact it makes on the universe.
We notice things like gravitational lensing, which is areas in the universe where we have intense gravity that actually bends light, according to Einstein's general theory of relativity, but we don't see the mass that's there in order to generate that gravity. We don't see what's actually bending the light.
Some researchers believe the leading candidate for a dark matter particle is a WIMP, or weakly interacting massive particle. Because WIMPs interact so weakly with ordinary matter, they are extremely hard to detect.
Even though we don't know what a WIMP is exactly, because we've never seen one, we do know, based on the properties that we've derived from what dark matter does in the universe, what that fingerprint should look like.